If you knew how the world ended, you'd be depressed too. My name's Chris. I've traveled through time looking for something to lift my spirits. I haven't found it. But I've come close with this guy, Brad Price.
Ladies and gentlemen,
he has his own TV show. His best friend Lou produces it. Evil Mr. Blackheart does his best to get the show canceled. They call it the Brad Price Variety Hour.
You see Brad? Have you seen Brad? Have you seen Brad? All over for you. What are you doing?
Research. Well, what's the problem?
Brad, we still have, like, so much to do, and Blackheart is breathing down my neck, and if we don't get everything done in time, we could be in trouble. Let me tell you, nothing could go wrong.
All right, Lou, all right. You seem a little stressed. What can I do to help?
Well, our first guest is in the green room. Why don't you go there and grab the Scrabble champ?
Anything for you, Lou.
I'll do that.
Thanks, Brad.
Gee whiz, Brad, it's such a good...
Brad, what are you doing?
I stabbed the Scrabble champion.
No, I asked you to grab the Scrabble champion.
No, I distinctively remember you saying stab the Scrabble champion.
Oh, no, I said grab the Scrabble champion.
No, what I heard was stab the Scrabble champion.
Well, then you gotta clean out your ears, my friend, because I definitely said grab.
Stab!
Grab!
Stab,
grab!
Stab,
grab!
Stab,
grab!
Stab,
grab!
Check this out on the tape. What can I do to help?
Well, our first guest is in the green room. Why don't you go there and stab the Scrabble champ?
See that, Lou? I told you said stab.
Stab the Scrabble champ.
Yeah, Brad, I guess I owe you a soda pop.
Yes. Stab! Stab! Stab!
Anything for you,
Lou? Let's go start the show!
Knock, knock! It's the Brad Price Variety Hour!
Hey, everyone, and welcome to the Brad Price Variety Hour. Now, there's a lot of bagpipers in the news lately, and what's the difference between a bagpipe and an onion? Nobody cries when you chop up a bagpipe! So Congress just passed a bill today, this week, on birth control, and what do bagpipers use for birth control? Their personalities! What do you call 10 bagpipers at the bottom of the ocean? A good start. That's the moral. We've got a great show for you today. We've got Dale, the trout-juggling forest ranger, a vegetable-loving rocketeer, and the world's nerdiest dog. All that and more. Oh, but it looks like it's time for my favorite part of the show, when we pick our secret word, so let's do it. Oh, okay. Could be a little. Hey, everybody, it's producer Lulu. Come on in. Lou, looks like we got our work cut out for us today on the secret word.
We sure do, Brad. And without our Scrabble champ, backed out last second.
Yeah.
Very unprofessional, might I add. We are in a bit of a jam, but luckily, I am always prepared for this. I finally have a chance to use my sock puppets.
Oh, all right, cool.
Well, Martha, don't you think?
Well, Mr. Price, you slipped up. And now it's time to pay the Blackheart Piper for what you did to me. Get the body!
Oh, Mr. Son, you're drunk. You're drunker than I am. You're drunker than I am.
Dramatic.
You're a slut. No, you're the slut. Oh, why? Why? You should be head of the history department right now. Instead, you're just a schmo. Sure. Shut up! Shut up! Shut up!
No! No, dude, I'll sleep with the other guy! And because I'm not afraid of you, Virginia Woolf!
So you know who I am.
Brad Price?
Oh, hey, Blackheart.
For the last time I checked, I called the shots around here. I was the alpha male.
You were the pigeon.
Alright.
I get you a guest. A damn good guest.
Hey, look here.
And you replace him with Richard Burton on a sock.
Come on. That was pretty good.
Don't you know anything about the biz, funny boy? This cannot be your main act.
Come on, everybody loves Lou.
Yeah, everybody loves Lou.
Nobody loves Lou. Nobody. Not even your mother. Take your sock and get the heck out of here.
Come on, Blackheart.
I spent 5 hours.
Did you really need to do that, Blackheart? I mean,
Price.
Just the show's just starting.
Eye to eye. If we were playing a game of chess, you'd be in what we call checkmate. Put that nerdy and obscure man into this seat.
What am I supposed to do with this guy?
Look, attract the demographic, Price. Or your days are numbered. And that pink slip is coming your way.
Well, the Scrabble champ, how many points do you get for spelling the word jerk? You know, we should take this time now to go to a commercial. So when we get back, we'll be back with more Brad Price Variety Hours. So stay tuned. Don't touch that, please. Can someone take this guy probably to the hospital? That's where you're gonna need to go. Every kid wants to be an astronaut.
I want to be a veterinarian.
Every cool kid wants to be an astronaut.
And now you can too.
Yay!
Hi, I'm TV's Brad Price. Space Camp is back, and now it's extreme. Everything's better when it's extreme, right, kids?
Yeah!
Experience astronaut living conditions.
It's what the astronauts eat.
I had a gold tango. Oh,
do it in your suit, kiddo. It's what the astronauts do.
Real space flight simulator.
Yeah.
Captain?
When's our turn?
Your turn? Well, good day. You're not ready for this. Here, go play with some of these illegal fireworks. I mean, test rockets.
Yes.
One of these days, who's gonna be riding on one of them?
Experience the G's of space.
All right, kid, just get in the space capsule.
I'm late for the track.
Like I told you, No, wait. Hey! So you think you're ready for Brad's awesome extreme space camp? Do you think you have the right stuff? And by right stuff, I mean the $85 entry fee?
Then call now. First 30 callers will get to walk on the moon simulator.
I don't hear moonwalking.
And free astronomer lessons.
Congratulations, cadet. I'm obscure.
I don't think so.
Godspeed.
Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Brad Price Variety Hour. Now, before the break, our boss, Mr. Blackheart, made some threats. But don't let that ruin your good time here on the show. Here on the Brad Price Variety Hour, it's all about having fun with your friends.
Hey, what's up, Brad?
Hey, speaking of which, it's Mailman Jules. How's it going, Mailman Jules?
21st century, that's Email Man Jules.
Wow, Email Man Jules, that's pretty cool.
Thanks. So how's the show been going?
Awesome. Though Blackheart said that if we didn't get enough ratings, he'd cancel the show.
Well, what can I do to help?
Well, we gotta get the secret word said, so by any chance, have you delivered any mail to anybody with any rare diseases?
Oh, bubonic plague, bionic plague.
Well, I was thinking more towards early last century, but...
I've been going through your email.
Oh, cool!
Maybe this right here will help you out.
Very nice, very nice. Thanks a lot, Jules.
Solid.
Let's play this tape.
You gotta be kidding.
Are you tired of being overweight?
Huh? You're not trying to sell me another one of those diet plans.
Well, you're in luck, because this program doesn't involve dieting or exercise. You too can have these results in just 3 easy steps. Step 1, step in front of the mirror, get depressed. Step 2, unfold your patented fat pants. Step 3, hold fat pants up in front of you and see how good you look.
Not only am I the president, I'm also a client. Go, take my fat pants.
Fat pants!
Howdy y'all, welcome back to the Brad Price Variety Hour. Now we got little numbers set up for you right now, a little something I like to call waiting for the bus. Late again. Looks like I'm waiting for the bus.
Excuse me, God, sir.
Yeah.
Do you know what time this bus arrives?
12:15.
I guess we're waiting for the bus.
Excuse me, kind sirs. Do you know what time the bus?
You know what that sound means? That means it's a time machine. Let's go check that out. Hey, depressed teacher Chris. How's the future?
More disappointing than you could possibly imagine.
Oh, come on, depressed future Chris. Who do you got for us today?
I brought one of our great nation's greatest presidents, Franklin Delano Roosevelt.
Oh, terrific. This is great. The secret word should be a piece of cake.
That was the worst time machine I've ever been in.
Wow, thanks a lot, depressed future Chris. Where are you off to next?
I think I'll go stare at myself as an infant. That was the last time I can remember truly being happy.
Awesome! Come on, FDR. Wow, I'm a big fan. Big fan. Huh. Seems to be something wrong with your legs. Have you, contracted any diseases lately?
No. Though there is a disease that is sweeping this great nation of ours. And it's called the Great Depression.
Yeah, FDR, but I'm talking about you personally. How's your central nervous system?
What is the nature of this line of questioning? Is this a Willie Hearst publication? I'm supposed to be here plugging my new deal.
But aren't you afraid that if you ignore your disease, you'll die and then leave the country in the hands of trigger-happy Truman?
The only thing we have to fear is fear itself and Dracula.
All right, FDR, but seriously, you're having trouble walking. I think maybe there's certain health issues here that we aren't getting to.
I completely understand, Mr. Blackerheart. If he doesn't say the secret word in 5 minutes, then he's effed, and that stands for fired. Thought of that myself. No shit.
My mother never said that. Good day to you, Mr. Price.
Quick, FDR, before you go, the Japanese are going to bomb Pearl Harbor.
Brad, there's no time for that. Now look, we can't just rely on FDR and all his fancy government handouts to solve all our problems. We need to get the secret word said, or else you and I are out of a job.
Uh-oh.
So let's get you to a hospital stat.
You're right. Come on, FDR, you're coming with me. Quick, get in this wheelchair.
Where's that time machine?
To the hospital.
Wait, what do you got?
Mumps?
What do you have?
Measles.
What do you have?
Bionic plague.
Wait, what do you got?
Multiple stab wounds.
Oh, yeah. What do you got?
Polio. Brad, we're canceled.
What? Are you serious? We said the secret word.
Brad, what do you call a bunch of bagpipers with nothing better to do?
Oh.
Apparently the majority of our viewership.
Ah, great.
Brad, you are reckless. Give me your badge and gun.
You can't be serious, Lou.
Price!
Oh, jeez. Great.
And the ankle holster?
Not Lucinda.
Oh yeah.
Jeez.
I'll never work with this.
Guys, I don't know how to say this, but FDR was right.
About what?
About everything! About social justice, about the economy, and about Dracula's. Especially about Dracula's.
Lou, throw me Lucinda.
You got it, Brad. Glad you're back.
Just like old times, eh, Lou?
Is that all there is? Is that all there is? If that's all there is, my friends, then let's keep dancing. Let's break out the booze.
I never flow.
If that's all there is. And when I was 12 years old, my daddy took me to the circus, the greatest show on earth. There were clowns and elephants and dancing bears, and a beautiful lady in pink tights flew high above our heads. And as I sat there watching, I had the feeling that something was missing. I don't know what, but when it was all over, I said to myself, is that all there is to the circus? Is that all there is? Is that all there is?
That's the show. Hope you enjoyed it more than I did.